Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In today's video, we're going to create this glossy heart effect using Illustrator and Photoshop. First, we'll be using the Illustrator software to create out the 3D look using mesh option. Then, we'll come back to Photoshop and apply this nice effect. We'll apply the glossy effect, we'll add these details using the pen tool and much more. So let's go to Illustrator and check out how we begin this design. So here, if you check it out, you can see I have created this heart shape in 3D using 3D Extreme Bevel option. And after that, I have used the mesh options and applied a nice color tone to give the 3D look. So let's begin with the design process. Open a new Illustrator document for this first and select the ellipse tool. So select the ellipse tool and draw the circle. For this, apply a plain color. So let's apply any color and let's remove the stroke color. Now using the direct selection tool, select the top anchor point and drag it down using the shift pressed. Then select this one also and drag it down. Now using the anchor point tool, you'll find this under pen option. Click on this to break the points and here click and drag. And after that, click the other handle and drag it up. Now using the direct selection tool, you can adjust the handles. So select the handles and let's give a nice curved shape to give the shape of heart. Let's extend this a little bit up and this also. After that, let's drag this down a little bit to give that nice curve effect below and again like this. So we got a nice shape of heart. Now next thing we're going to do is to apply the 3D bevel and ambers option, but before that we have to make all the corners round. So select a direct selection tool and select this anchor point. And you can see this circular icon. If you select it, you can make the corners round very easily. But if you're using the previous version of Illustrator software, you have to do it manually. So make sure that this corner is round. So I'll just select this and drag it up to make the corner round. In the same way, at the bottom, you can see we have got this pointed corner. So select this and drag it up to make the corners round. So we have given a nice curved shape at the top and this also. Now let's apply 3D bevel option. So select the shape and go to effect 3D extrude bevel option. So here we go, we got a extrude bevel option panel. Take the preview option and you can see the changes. So now let's apply rounded bevel. So select that and increase the height to give the soft blending here. Let's adjust the angle by clicking and drag. Let's make it a little downward and a little bit of angular like that. Let's do some adjustment with the extrude depth as well. So you can reduce the thickness, increase or reduce the thickness here. So let's give it around maybe 60 and let's play around with this and I think this is good. Let's click OK and we got a nice heart shape in 3D format. Now go to object and expand the shape. So expand appearance, then ungroup it twice. All the shapes are now separated out. Let's create another duplicate of this. So select all and with the alt press, click and drag it down to create another duplicate. We'll do all the adjustments here. So we'll be using this for our color reference and we'll be doing all the changes here. Now select all the shapes and go to Pathfinder and unite them. This will combine all the shapes and make it a single object. The next step is to apply the mesh option. But before that, we have to reduce all these anchor points. To reduce the number of anchor points here, select the object and go to Object Path and click Simplify. And under Simplify panel, you got two options. For this, keep the angle threshold to 0 degrees because it will maintain your shape and set the curve to the precision value. So if you keep it 100, you get a sufficient amount of anchor points. But if you reduce a little bit more, you can see that the shape is maintained, but the number of anchor points has reduced. So do the adjustments and make sure that the shapes are maintained as well as the number of anchor points are low. I think this is good and click OK. So we got a shape. We have reduced all the anchor points. Now let's apply mesh. So select the mesh tool here. And if you go here, you can see now you can easily apply. So first I'll click here like that. First one here, second one, I'll keep it around here. and third one around here. For the fourth one, I'll set it around here, and the fifth one, let's set it around here. So we have balanced our mesh here carefully because we don't want to apply large number of mesh because it will be difficult to apply the colors, so that you can select individually and give the exact color you want to give to your design. Let's choose red color under color picker and apply it. So we got a bright red color. Now let's select the anchor points from the corners. So select all of them with a shift pressed, select them and go to color picker panel, and here let's make it darker. So this way, in the same way, select all the remaining anchor points at the corners, select them individually like this, and go to color picker and let's give dark color like that. So if while giving this, you notice that if you give a dark color at the edges, it's started to give volume to our design. So select everything which is at the corners and just apply dark color to. Select them, go to path color picker option, choose dark color and apply. Here also, let's select them all and apply a little darker color like this. Now, over here, we want to give some highlights. So select this anchor point and let's give a yellow color highlight to this. So I'll go to color picker and choose yellow color from here like that, and let's give it yellowish tone like that. So it's nice. Now let's select this one, and with the eye picker I can choose any color I want to give around here. So I want to give a middle color tone from here like that, then select this anchor point, give little reddish and yellowish color tone so that we can give a nice fade like a 3D shape. I'm using the shortcut A for the selection tool and I for the eyedropper tool. So select this and using the eye, again activate the eye picker tool and let's apply some nice color tone to give that nice blend here. So if I click outside, you can see we have given a nice blend here. Here we can do little more adjustments. So select the anchor points at these corners and let's choose some darker tone from here so that it blends out properly like this. Let's select this one eye picker and like this. Here, over here also, we want to give some brighter tone, so select the anchor points and for this let's apply some white color like that and make it little pinkish like that, this way. And now let's select this one and let's blend it properly like this. Here we want to give some dark shade because it's a convergent area. Here the surfaces are coming closer, so there will be more darkness. So select the anchor point, this, and with the eyedropper tool let's select some dark color like that. We can choose much more darker color, so we can go here and select the darker tone from here if you want to do it, and after that select this and let's blend this out like that. Then blending it make it more realistic. See, if you check it out, we can see that there's a depth now there. We can just go around and do the color adjustments properly like that. Here let's give some darkness, so some shades, dark shades. Select this anchor points and choose some dark color from here, maybe from here you can choose any color like that to give that nice blend. Select this one, apply the same color tone and we got a nice interesting effect here. So just keep on adjusting until you get the nice depth, nice 3D feel. So once you have given a nice color tone to the mesh, the next thing is to go to Photoshop and create out the glossy effect. So for that, let's create a new document and I'll just drag and drop the vector to Photoshop. So click drag drop to Photoshop, scale up the size and enter. So place it around here. Now let's do the adjustments. For this, let's apply a gradient color first. So I'll apply some white and here gray, or maybe a little bluish gray, so that we can get that feel of sky. And if we check it out, okay, there is bluish gray and here we got a yellowish gray. So let's do that adjustment. Go to gradient overlay, choose it, and here let's choose some yellowish color too, like that. Click okay. Okay, so once you have added a nice gradient color to the background, let's do the adjustments now. So if you check out our design, let's open the group here. You can see that we have got a lots of layers in there. This is our main object layer. Then after that, we have added one layer on top, which is an overlay to give the sharpness. Then after that, we have added these patches using the mask option. And later we added this nice glossiness, then highlights, then this lens flare effect, and done. So let's do that. So scale it up a little bit more. So let's create a new duplicate of this layer. So click and drag it here and it will create a new duplicate. Change the layer to overlay and you can see it has increased the intensity. That's, you can adjust the intensity around here. Now let's create one more duplicate of this. And we'll use this to add the highlights. So let's change it to screen. And if you check it out, our layers are in screen format because it will give brightness to our design. So we need the brightness effect. And the first thing we're going to do is to mask out the rest of the region. So I'll use the pen tool, select the shape option, and let's draw some shapes here. So let's follow it. Then complete the design like that. Now you can do the adjustments with the direct selection tool. So select and make the adjustments, make it curve a little more like that, and here like that. Now with the control plus, click on the thumbnail to make a selection. Then selecting this layer, apply mask. This will mask out the region. Now you can hide out this, and this one you can create a duplicate one more and it will add up the brightness here. Now we'll do the same thing for the corners as well. So if you see, study the shape, it's like this, and same here as well. So let's create that out using the pen tool. So select the pen tool, draw the shape. Let's make it around till here. Then let's remove the fill color. Then around here, let's make a curve like this. Then let's complete the design. And this way we got on the shape, make a selection. Let's create one more duplicate of this. And I place it on top. And now apply mask. And for this, let's change the blend mode to overlay like that. And we can create one more duplicate of this to add up the details. In the same way, let's create one more duplicate of this, bring it to the top, change the blend mode to screen. Now for this, let's draw one more shape. So from here, let's draw a shape like this, or maybe let's see the path. So like this, click, remove the fill color, like follow along the path, then finish it and complete the shape. Let's do some adjustments. So I'll just select this and drag it down a little bit like that. Once you're done with the control, press click on thumbnail to make a selection, then apply the mask and create one more duplicate. And if you check it out, let's increase the bright opacity of each of the layers. So select all, let's increase the opacity to 100%. And we got a nice effect here. Now to give more depth, I have given a drop shadow effect here. So let's give that drop a shadow effect. So select the bottom layer first. So this is our bottom layer for this. Open the layer style panel. Select drop shadow. Choose, let's increase the distance a little bit. And let's uncheck the global light and change the angle down 90 degree, distance around, and let's reduce the opacity. Let's keep it around 2. Let's check it out. Maybe 1. That's 1. And maybe 2. And opacity around like that. Let's choose a red color, maybe dark red color from here to give a nice blend. And click OK. So we got, have given that. Let's copy the same effect and drag and drop it to our other layer. So this is our base layer for this, and this is our base layer for the third shape. So with the Alt press, click and drag and drop it there. Then again, click and drag and drop it there. Now, let's change the angles. So let's change the angle to this, like this, to get that effect. Increase the opacity and click OK. Do the same adjustment for here. Let's change the angle of rotation like that. Reduce the size, increase the opacity, and done. Now let's add some glossiness. So select our main design, double click on that, open the layer style panel and apply inner glow. So here we got inner glow. Under inner glow, let's increase the size, and we got a nice glossy effect. You can see like that brightness. So let's give that like this. You can adjust the opacity here, and let's keep it like that for a while. In the next part, we'll look at how to add some lens flare effect to design to give a nice glossy look. We'll also create some cover designs using the same elements. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.